video, I'm going to show you how I make tray charms in two methods, one with epoxy stickers and the other with diamond glaze. But first, we're going to start off with the first method with epoxy stickers. First, I take my 1-inch hole punch and I cut out the photo. You have to cut kind of close to the picture to make sure that you can cut out the circle. And once you align everything and get everybody in the picture, like in the little circle, then you punch it and it cuts it out. And there's the picture. And next, I am going to put some super glue. I think it's like Aileen's jewelry glue on the bottom. It dries super fast. And I put the picture at the bottom and make sure you align it first, because once you put the picture down, it's permanent. And you just press down to make sure that the glue is all around the back of the picture so the picture doesn't lift up. And make sure you get off any excess glue. And then you get your 1-inch epoxy sticker. And you get a good grip on it. And you align it on the photo. I like to put the edge of the sticker on the edge, on the inside edge of the tray charm, to align it. And then you press down to create a seal. And make sure that there are no bubbles between the sticker and the photo. And you press down to make sure it's got a good stick to it. And that is the first method. And I'm just showing you how it looks at the end, making sure everything is all right before I put it down. And here's the second method with diamond glaze. You don't cut out your picture with the 1-inch hole punch because the tray charm is too big. It's bigger than the 1-inch, and I'm not sure how to measure it to see how big the space is, but I just take a picture that I've already outlined and put in there, and I just trace that shape on the picture so I could cut the shape out. And I make sure I trace it with pencil, because if you do it with pen, you'll be able to see the marks. With pencil, it's kind of invisible, just use an indent. And then I cut out the square so I could cut a little bit better. And this part is very tedious. And it takes a while because you don't have a hole punch. It's the exact measurement of the tray charm. And I should have mentioned that I should have laminated it first, because I would have only had to cut once. And then this is the part where you laminate the photo. Since I have an inkjet printer, I have to laminate my photos first because it is water-based. If you use a water-based glue with a water-based ink, your picture will come out blurry and all the ink will run together and you won't be able to see the picture anymore. So you align it at the top first to make sure there's no bubbles between the sticker and the photo. And you rub down because there's ridges in the photo. So you have to make sure it's smooth. And then the next part is very tedious also. You cut around the picture so you can laminate everything together. And that creates the seal to protect the ink so it doesn't run together. And so you'll be able to see the picture clearly. In here, I just put the picture on the inside to make sure that it fits. I don't want it to fit perfectly to where it gets stuck. I just want it to have a little bit of space in between the photo and the edge of the tray charm so I can be able to maneuver it when I before I put the glue down to make any adjustments. And here I am cutting off any extra edges to make sure that everything fits perfectly and to make sure it's as close to a perfect circle as I can get it. And here I finally got it right and it fits perfectly. And I can take it in and out when I need to. And here I use the same super glue to adhere it to the tray charm so it doesn't move. This glue does not let anything move. Once you put anything on this glue, it will not move anywhere. And if you get any on your fingers, use pure acetone to get it off because that's the only thing that works. And here you just align it and make sure that your picture isn't crooked. And you press down and you get off any extra glue around the edges. That's what I'm doing with this paintbrush. When the glue dries, you'll be able to see it because it turns white under the diamond glaze. And so you press down, make sure there's no excess glue. And here is how it looks in this step. So I set it to the side for a few minutes so that the glue under dry. That's the ideal way to do it. So you make sure that there's no glue that mixes with the diamond glaze because it does turn white when it makes contact with each other. So here's the diamond glaze. It dries crystal clear. You don't have to worry about it being cloudy. When you pour it out, it is cloudy, but it dries clear. You pour it a little to make sure there's no air bubbles. And sometimes air bubbles do come through, but when it's wet, you can easily pop them with the paintbrush. And you spread it around and make sure you get all the crevices to create a layer over top of the photo. Just go around and make sure it's even. And don't use too much because if you use too much, it's going to be kind of hard to get some of it out. Go all around. Pop any air bubbles that you might see. The little ones don't pop. Air bubbles are inevitable. They're gonna happen, but you just have to make sure that you don't really have any before it dries, and you lay it flat so it can dry.